Good morning, the students of class 6. Welcome to our social science e-learning class. Welcome everyone, Ankita, Vishnu, Salma, Tanishtha, Srija, Srijita, Aroni, Mehtab. Okay, so students, previous class in our social science geography class, we have discussed about the lithosphere and some the continents of our Earth. Now today we are going to discuss the rest of the continents of the Earth, okay, from lithosphere. So open page number 32 from your geography book and follow the book. So previous class I have discussed about the Asia, Africa and Europe, okay, the three continents. Now today we are going to discuss the North America, South America, Antarctica and or Oceania, Antarctica or Oceania, okay. And Australia or Oceania and Antarctica, okay. So students, today we are going to discuss these four continents. So first one, North America. So North America situated in the northern hemisphere, completely situated in the northern hemisphere means north of the equator. And in North America, surrounded in three sides, surrounded by water. On the western side, the Pacific Ocean was situated, Pacific Ocean is situated, in the eastern side the Atlantic Ocean situated, and in the northern side the Arctic Ocean situated, and in southern portion the South America, the North America linked to South America by a very narrow strip of land called Isthmus of Panama, okay, Isthmus of Panama, and it's situated in a sea that is called Caribbean Sea in south of the North America. The region around this area, it is called the Caribbean Sea, and lot of islands also situated in the Caribbean Sea, and together they called West Indies, such as Jamaica, Trinidad and Tobago, Sao Tome and Principe, Dominican Republic, etc. Okay, Cuba, okay. So now students, this is the North America, and in North America the biggest mountain range in North America, it is the Rocky Mountain Range, okay. So Rocky Mountain Range, so this is about the North America. Now next one, it is the South America. So what is the location of South America? South America also situated, most of the part of the continent situated in the southern hemisphere, and the equator also passes through this continent, and there is a country called Ecuador. This country also, the equator also passes through Ecuador, so that's why the name of the country is also named after equator, it is Ecuador, okay. And another important thing, this continent also surrounded all the sides by three sides by oceans. In the western side, it is the Pacific Ocean, eastern side Atlantic Ocean, in the southern side it is Antarctic Ocean, okay. So in this way, South America also surrounded by the oceans. And world's longest mountain range, that is Andes, world's longest mountain range, Andes, also situated in South America. As well as the longest, the largest river of the world, it is the Amazon. The longest, it is the largest river as per the water flown through it throughout the year. So it is the largest river, and its name is Amazon, also situated in the southern South America. Okay. Now next one, it is Oroni, Guam. Guam also a country, I will tell you now, that it is situated in Australia or Oceania. It's a small island country, Guam, okay. So Australia or Oceania, Australia or Oceania is another, sorry, Oceania is there. Australia or Oceania is another continent, and it is the smallest continent and called island continent also, Australia or Oceania. Okay. And different countries also present in this continent, and most of them are islands. And the biggest island, it is the Australia, the country, and another island, it is the New Zealand. It is also island country, divided among some small islands. Except this, Papua New Guinea, Micronesia, Polynesia, Nauru, and also Guam. So these are some islands, Marshall Islands. Okay, these are also situated in this continent, Australia or Oceania. And it's also surrounded on all sides by oceans, and it is situated in Pacific Ocean and Southern Pacific Ocean, and the eastern side and western side of this continent, the Indian Ocean situated. Okay, students, and southern side, obviously, the Antarctic Ocean, and northern side and the eastern side is the Pacific Ocean, and in the western side, the Indian Ocean situated on surrounding the island continent. And Great Barrier Coral Reef, it is the largest coral reef also situated near this Australia Oceania continent. Okay, so these are about these three continents. Now the last one, this is the Antarctica. Antarctica, completely situated in the southern hemisphere, and is a huge continent. And the South Pole lies almost in the middle of the Antarctica. And as it located in the South Polar region, it is permanently covered with a thick layer of ice. All over the year, it is covered with a thick layer of ice. In some places, it's also 1 kilometer deep. Okay, 1 kilometer deep, the depth of the ice. Or only it is a Marshall Island, people live also, or some army base may be situated. Okay, because in different this type of some thousands and tiny islands are there in Pacific Ocean, unknown islands also there where no people live. In Pacific Ocean, it is a huge area, and some of these islands also used by India, also used by the US Army, United States Army, okay, for their some other purposes, okay, for as an army base. So now, in Antarctica, there are no permanent human settlement, but because of some research work, some research workers, they live there in some specific settlements, specially made settlements. Okay, these research centers were almost most of the developed countries such as USA, Australia, and European countries such as Norway, Sweden, Finland, okay, Germany, the France, they also established, UK, they established their research station. India also established their research stations in south, in the Antarctica, and their name is Maitri and Dakshin Gangotri. Maitri and Dakshin Gangotri. Okay, so these are the two research stations of India situated in Antarctica. They try to find out various sources and minerals, natural gas and oils, as well as the life exist on that continent. This continent, very few animals, they can live here. They are, and the mammals, two type of mammals live there, that is the seals and penguins. So it's a continent also for the penguins. Famous for the penguins. And another important question may come in exam, that which two continents situated in the south of the equator? Okay, completely south of the equator. It is the Australia or Oceania and Antarctica. This is the correct answer. So these two continent situated completely south of the equator. North Pole, North Pole is situated in the Arctic Ocean in Northern Hemisphere. Obviously, North Pole, but no continent was there. North Pole also, most of the spaces of the North Pole in Arctic Ocean, frozen. And Greenland is very near to that place. South Pole continents are these two, the Australia or Oceania, not South Pole. South Pole, it is Antarctica, okay. South Pole situated in Antarctica, in the middle of the Antarctica, and the two continents situated in the south of the equator, means Southern Hemisphere, these are Australia or Oceania and Antarctica. They completely situated on the south of the equator. Okay. Now, I am going to discuss another domains of the Earth, that is the hydrosphere. Okay. So, you know that hydro means water in Latin. Okay. So, hydrosphere means the domains contains water. And in our earth, the 3/4 of our earth covered with contains water, and more than 71% of the earth also covered with oceans. And that's why it is called a blue planet, and only 29% is with land. So hydrosphere consists of water in all its forms, not only the oceans, but ponds, rivers, lakes, glaciers, or ice sheets, and ground, underground water, as well as the water vapor. Everything consists in the hydrosphere. So, in hydrosphere, more than 97% water present, it is saline water. So, I am drawing a pie chart. So, with the help of pie chart, you can understand easily what is. Okay. So, only 3% is drinkable and 97% ocean water. We cannot drink that water because it is very much salty. Okay. So, all of you understood this? Mehtab, Sanchita, Aroni. Okay. And Aroni, Greenland is not totally civilized, but is came under the jurisdiction of Denmark. Denmark ruled actually in Greenland, okay. And Eskimos, they also lived in Greenland. Now, this is 97% ocean water, saline water. We cannot drink this water. Now, the 3% drinkable, out of this 3% drinkable water, 2% water stored as ice sheets. Mostly on the North Pole and South Pole, on the top of the mountains like Himalaya, Andes, in Alps, okay, Tian Shan Mountains. So, in the top of these mountains, as well as in North Pole and South Pole. So, only 1% water is available for us. Out of them, only 0.03% we can consume through, and these are underground water. Okay. So, fresh water for the human usage is very less on the surface of Earth. Hence, despite being a blue planet, we face a shortage of water. So, that's why we should conserve water okay, without conserving water, we cannot live so long in our earth, because without water, our life is not, the presence of life is not possible in the surface of earth. Okay. So in many European countries and developed countries like Japan also and Korea also, they recycle the water, they reuse the water. Okay. Then they are not waste the water. Okay, Sanjita, 1% water is drinkable in liquid form. Yes, it is in liquid form. Okay, not only liquid form, less than 1% is in liquid form, because water vapor also includes in 1%, Sanjita. Okay, so less than 1%. In class 7, you will read in detail about this, the divisions of water, how much water we can use. Okay. So, students, today that much. Or only no, water cycle is not available, because when we waste wet water, all the rivers' water, they mixed with the oceans, so that's why. And all the drainage system, they directly connected to the oceans. So the drinkable water, okay, non-saline water, they directly mixed with the saline water. So we cannot use the ocean water again. So that's why it is a big problem for us. In some countries or in South India also, the people, they invented some process of water conservation, such as rooftop water conservation. Their roofs are totally sealed. Whenever rain occurred, the rainwater they collected, and through a pipe, the rainwater stored in an underground tank. And through that tank, with using the pump, they circulate the water all over the buildings. Okay, so in this way, rainwater harvesting, rooftop water harvesting is very much popular in some countries, as well as in South India and cities like Chennai, where water scarcity is a big problem. Yes, rainwater harvesting. Okay, Sanchita, do you understand rainwater harvesting? In rooftop, they blocked all the rain pipes, and the rain pipes are directly connected with the underground tank. Okay. And they can use that rainwater for their daily life. So this is a very good idea for water recycling and water conservation. Very good. Okay, Aroni, would you trade water with aliens? No, we don't know that aliens are exist or not, so that's why we cannot trade. Okay. It's a theory, just a theory. We should reuse and recycle water. Only that we can live long in the earth. Okay, so if you have any question regarding this two subunits, the second part of the lithosphere and the first part of hydrosphere, then ask me. Microorganism, yes, microorganism also exist. Okay. Projects yet not given. I'll give you the project before the puja vacation, and you can make those projects in puja vacation. Okay, students. So thank you, everyone. Thank you for joining this class. See you in the next class with the portion oceans and atmosphere. Previous class I did not. Okay, Sanchi, the lithosphere. Okay, just a minute. Lithosphere is a solid portion of the earth which we lived. It is called lithosphere, and lithosphere also divided into 7 continents. I have discussed already 4 continents today, and the rest of the continents previous class, if you check that video, in this video I have already discussed in detail about the 3 continents and the lithosphere. Okay, so I hope you will check that. So thank you, everyone. Bye.